Uh-oh, Kodok's flexing again. Hey, everybody, this is Kodok here, and I managed to get my hands on another diamond starter. This case, it's the newest one, Diamond Webam. I think there might be one that's a bit newer that also includes the Fade Ninja, hence why in the Pyravian video it was the only thing we got in there. But this is a really exciting pack. It's the first diamond starter I have found in the wild, and it's going to be really good because it even includes a Bakugan I have never reviewed before, and that is Phaedrus, which was one of the ones I showed off at Toy Fair, which looked really cool. It, of course, comes with the Diamond Webam, which, from what I can tell here, is the nicest looking diamond yet. I mean, I know I keep saying that about the Diamond Ultras, but we finally have one that looks like it has completely shed the use of the colored parts, except for the feet, which is okay. I mean, like, the Diamond Dragonoids have, like, the horns and stuff like that. And we have Chaos Kubbo, who has a solid white head instead of a solid blue head. Although you can kind of tell what it is based on that giant face there. They're not really going to be disguising that thing from anybody. Anyway, it says complexity level 1 for Webam. Webam is a great design. It has no mark on the side, whereas the earlier waves would have said Battle Brawlers here. And on the back, a quick look, we have the characters again, and gee, I wonder who this is supposed to be. But yeah, it contains the normal Diamond Starter spread, which is going to include the character cards and the diamond forms of their character cards. Although, unlike the Maxitor one, to my understanding, none of the diamond forms are particularly rare. That was one thing that made the Maxitor one stand out, is it is, to my understanding so far, the only Bakugan toy product to contain an awesome rare or rarer card. We'll have to see if any of that changes. There's rumors that GameStop is going to get a unique 5-pack, so we'll just have to see. And on the bottom here, they have a picture of the old Baku storage, but they have a picture of the new red battle arena, which comes with Pyrus Phaedrus. And like I said, Phaedrus is a good design. And the Pyrus Phaedrus actually looks like it might be a good Bakugan. I believe it's a double Fire Fist, so it might actually be something to keep an eye on. Anyway, let's get this thing open. Huh, I guess getting the Diamond Trox Ultra in my regular Trox Ultra must have caught up to me, because instead of Webam, Diamond Webam, I got the card Web Snare, which came with the regular Webam from the other video I showed off. I mean, it's nice, like I said in that video, it's nice to include a card with the character on it, so that we can see the character and we get to see the character doing something cool. The other ones, though, I was able to get the diamonds for. Webam and Kubbo come with the same old cores that they did in their regular form. Phaedrus, however, comes with the top power plus 650B magic shield and the plus stealth strike helix core. So, interesting combination on something that is otherwise not terribly intimidating. A 305 on a Darkus isn't that great. Darkus isn't the best at building up B power. It's a lot better at boosting damage, which is why the Bakugan like Darkus Hyderus Ultra and Darkus Trox tend to be a lot more popular. They both also come with their diamond forms. Kubbo is a 710 for 6, and Phaedrus is a 709 for 4. So 1 point less damage for 2 points less. So Diamond Phaedrus is way better than Chaos Diamond Kubbo, I am afraid. Anyway, moving on. Leading off with Diamond Webam here, you know it, you love it. It's Ventus Webam, one of the best Bakugan released to date. It has a fantastic design, it has some pretty good stats, it has that lovely built-in reroll ability, and over the weekend when I was at the Bakugan days, it made mincemeat of my opponents by having a tendency to leap up when it grabs a core and grab their Bakugan to prevent it from opening. It is a surprisingly powerful character with, like I said, with all that it has going for it. It is easily one of the best Bakugan in my book. It, of course, also has the Diamond Webam evolution, which is a 1515 for 8. So it is literally a cheaper Diamond Maxitor Ultra. It also has a Maximus form, which is a 1214 for 7, but retains it that lovely reroll ability, which makes it so good. And speaking of so good, this is one of the best Ultra Diamonds to date because the whole thing pretty much is clear. I mean, we have the little feet here, which are contrary in color to the original Webam here. In fact, it's actually, they didn't do much to change the color scheme between the two Webams. They have the dark green feet instead of the light green feet, and a few of the applications of the normally sort of citrus lime green color have been replaced with the dark green of the plastic in order to more properly identify it, but otherwise it is remarkably unaltered. And like I said, most importantly, it, unlike a lot of Ultra Bakugan, it does not have those big garish colored pieces of plastic that break up the nice diamond look. Everything is clear. You can even see the magnet in there through that window there. I mean, they do have the colored pieces, but they are hidden. They are underneath in places where when it's normally unfurled, you won't see it. This is the closest to a perfect diamond Bakugan, a diamond ultra Bakugan that we have ever gotten. In fact, I think the feet, even though they are made of opaque plastic, work perfectly with the design. They give some nice eye-popping contrast to the nice clear look of the diamond. And oh dear, did that already get a little damaged? I guess, oh, that's just an effect of being on the clear plastic, I suppose. But we have the 400B power there printed in black. We have the latch, of course, which it's in the nice opaque plastic, but it means that the outer shells and the legs get to stay nice and clear. This is what we want to see, guys. This is fantastic. And especially since my current iteration of the Awesome Ones uses Webam now, it means...
Hello, ladies. I'm the man your man could brawl like, for my team is now diamonds.
And next we move on to Diamond Cubbo, the Zubul tributing bear. It still has that nice Tron look with the nice blue. Hey, have they actually, like... They've actually made these, like, metallic in color, the light blue on here. That actually looks really cool. They went with a metallic paint for the details on this guy, and I've got to say, that looks great when combined with the diamond. Everything just pops so nice and jewel-like and metallic. That looks spectacular, because the regular Cubbo, as you can see here, went with the more plain color. I did not expect to see this happen with this nice metallic tone here. It almost kind of looks like a custom. Of course, it's still Cubbo kind of the same way, and unfortunately the diamond kind of obliterates the detail, but it is still a very nice look thanks to the use of the metallic paint. Did they use metallic paint on the arms as well? Oh yeah, they did. The blue and the green, it's all done in that lovely metallic paint that just makes everything pop and stand out. Although the backpack, rather than blue, it's white as usual. Oh, and they actually left this part clear. That's kind of a nice touch, or I guess that's kind of how it would be. Or no, this is like a spot painted on, but that's kind of cool to have that open like that. There are a lot of really cool design choices here, especially that metallic paint. I'd love to see this kind of metallic paint happen on more diamonds to make them just that much shinier and more appealing. And finally, we have Phaedrus Core in its ball form. It looks like, rather than the usual black paint, they went with sort of a gunmetal here with some light color detail. So they tried to go for something a bit metallic, but it still looks really nice with the gunmetal here. We, of course, have the neck, and we have the legs. It's a bit difficult to make out the detail since this is the diamond version and the first time we're going over it, but I guarantee you it has a very nice look when opened up. Phaedrus is one of the nicest looking core Bakugan I have seen in a long time. This whole set is really, really nice. They made some very good choices on what to put in here. The Ventus Webam and the Darkus Phaedrus. And like I said, Phaedrus is one I haven't looked at before. We have like a fun, interesting little bolt there that's in green. I assume that's in green in all versions of it, and I assume these black painted areas are purple on the normal version, but I don't have the normal version, so I can't really show it off. Anyway, let's see how this thing opens. And here we have our Darkus Diamond Phaedrus, and it is another one that is a very, very impressive core Bakugan. A lot of people thought that this was actually an Ultra form, but the Phaedrus Ultra is actually the one that I mistakenly called Tico back in the Toy Fair video. So that one, a lot of people actually like the core version more because it actually looks like the sort of Asian serpent Shenlong dragon that its design is supposed to invoke. Or she's a very long girl. At least I'm pretty sure it's a she if the show is anything to go by despite the mustache. But anyway, it is still a very impressive core Bakugan. It's actually longer than Fangzor. It has a longer tail in this section here, and it has the head that goes beyond. So it's actually longer than Fangzor, and it is again a very nice design. It has these little legs that go down here with these green bolts that hold everything together. We have all this black detail, which I assume is purple in the final version, although we have some purple going down the spine as well. It's a very nice design. Where's the B power on this long one here? Oh, there it is. 300 right there on the other side, the side that I wasn't looking at. So Phaedrus might not have a lot of power. We haven't seen all of her Evos yet. I believe most of them will be coming out in Age of Auralus, which will be very interesting to look into. The Diamond Webam Starter Pack. These are some great diamonds. We're seeing the best Ultra Diamond to date because it has a lot of those clear parts that people really enjoy. We've got a look at a new Bakugan Phaedrus and the introduction of metallic elements to the diamond form. So this is going to be a really, this is going to be really fun going forward, seeing what else they do with the diamonds. I'm not sure what other diamonds I can get my hands on. I was unable to get my hands on either form of Diamond Gortheon, which is kind of disappointing to me. I did manage to get the Pegatrix Ultra, but you know, I don't like to do these sorts of videos to flex too much. This was more for the fun of showing off a really, really nice Ultra and a really, really nice new Bakugan. So we'll see if I manage to get some more diamonds in the future. Next time I might have something big, both figuratively and literally. But until next time, this is Kodak signing off. Bakugan Brawl, it's a big brawl. Bakugan Brawl is for it all. Bakugan Brawl, standing tall, we're the awesome ones. Powers in our hand, take a stand, saving everything.